I really come from a background where it was broken. My mother given to marriage at the age of 13, and I was born when she was 14, and then dumped in the streets when I was about 6 or 7. Started living under a bridge as a small boy, and I became a drug addict at an early age of my life, and stabbed someone with a knife at the age of about 13. Joined the freedom fighters in Zimbabwe, and it was from there that I had to shout, "There's no God, there's no God." Communism was the only answer. The hatred for a white man began when I was so small, when I saw them beating my father. So this day when I was given this bomb to go and plant it, I had that passion to go and kill as many white people as I could. As we walked towards the bank, we saw this big, massive tent by the roadside. And it so happened that it was from South Africa. And anything from South Africa to us was a taboo because of the white people, the way they tortured black people. And there were about 2,000-3,000 people inside singing praises to God. But we got there and I said, "Surround the tent in twos, every corner. And when I blow the whistle at 7 o'clock, throw the bombs inside, and I want every person inside to die. If one person escapes, I'll give you a gift of a bullet in your head." He said, "Okay, Steve, we'll do that." I said, "Well, since we've got 5 minutes, maybe let's go inside for 2 minutes only to look at the people we're about to kill." So we went inside with our weapons in the paper bags, sat right the last bench at the entrance, like it was left for us. They were singing choruses, but my friends, we started singing out of tune to disturb the meeting. And one preacher came and touched my shoulder, said, "Please, boys, keep quiet." And I pulled out my knife. I said, "Preacher, if you ever touch me, I'll kill you right now." And he left me. And all my gang turned towards me with shock of their life. And I said, "What?" Because they were surprised that I warned this preacher. I was that character. When I pulled out my knife, I would use it. When I took out my gun, I would shoot. But they were shocked to see that I'd warned this preacher. They invited a pretty girl from Soweto to share a testimony. And that girl put me off balance completely, because she was gorgeous. But the more she shared the testimony, she was, you know, shining with the glory of God. And then she invited another black evangelist, and this man stood up and read two verses. Romans 6 verse 23, "For the wages of sin is death." And the next thing, I was under deep conviction. And I was crying like a little child. The whole tent looked backwards at this boy who was crying. And I picked up my guns and my bombs and went forward. And that night was my turning point. As I was crying there, I said, "Jesus, have mercy upon me. I want to surrender my life to you." And the peace I got that night was unbelievable. No language can ever explain the peace and the joy I experienced that night. And that was my first time as well to laugh. And following that, I went to the police to surrender myself. And after 8 hours, they say, "If your Jesus has forgiven you, we forgive you too." And my new Bible, which I was given by a police officer, I didn't know how to read it, but I treasured so much. God, with a sense of humor, used a white man to adopt me. In spite of the laws at that time that no black people could live in the white area, you'd be arrested. So this man kept me for 15 years, in spite of the laws, and helped me to transform me to be what I am today. So he was the one who gave me the surname Lungu. Many people ask me, "Which Bible college do you go? Did you go?" I said, "Well, I went to Golgotha." That's where I said, "Where is Golgotha College?" I said, "At the cross where Jesus was crucified. That's where I've learned everything about, you know, about God." So to me, I can say my BA degree is born again. God has taken me around the globe, preaching the gospel, meeting, you know, presidents of different countries. They invite me, pay for my ticket, and preached around the United States, almost every state. 2 years ago, I was preaching at Pentagon to the CIA intelligence. They said, "You are the first black man to preach here." So I look at myself that God could, you know, choose a person who was thrown away by my mother. Little did she know that the boy I'm dumping today will travel around the globe and, you know, preach to statesmen. But, you know, God picks up a nobody and makes you a somebody.